Hey guys, good morning. I'm very happy you're here. I'm Rinske Dauna and today is gonna be a special video because I'm collaborating with Sarah Mack. Sarah Mack is a beautiful fluid artist. She's a joy to watch and she makes gorgeous artworks. So you should check her out if you haven't. We came up with a challenge and this is such a fun challenge. So if you guys want to do that as well, it's called the Do's and Don't Challenge. What does that mean? I'm giving her 3 do's and 3 don'ts. And she needs to make a painting with that. She gave me them as well. And I need to make a painting with that. So my do's are, do make a Dutch pour. All right, check. I can do that. Do use a palette knife. So here it gets interesting because I've never used a palette knife in my Dutch pour. So that's something that's fun with this challenge, of course, to use different tools or, yeah, think of a little bit out of the box. And do use some copper details. Then the don'ts are, don't use a square canvas, don't use a black base, and don't use a paintbrush. Okay, so I'm gonna start making that. I will do a split color base with gray and purple. I loved when I did the purple party. It's a video in my channel and I did 4 small paintings with different kind of purples and gray. So I thought, why not do a split color base with that? Also, you should definitely check out Sarah's video, of course, and see what kind of do's and don'ts I gave her and also what her painting will be. I have no clue as well, so I will check it out when our videos are live. Gonna be super fun. So without further ado, let's start painting. All right, I'm super excited to start with this one. Let's sum it up. Do use some copper details. Got some copper here. Do use a palette knife. Got it here. And I think I can combine those two as well. Do make a Dutch pour. Yeah, got the blow dryer ready, all good. Don't use a square canvas. This is not square. Don't use a black base. Not listening to the rules. But I'm gonna use a base with gray and a base with purple. So that's gonna change. Sorry, Sarah. And what was the other don't? Oh yeah, don't use a paint brush. Okay, not gonna use that. So let's start making the base here. Gray here. I sure hope I have enough made. And here. The purple. I really like this purple. Okay, so that looks beautiful. Let me get my colors. I have a deep violet, a gold, copper, and a sky blue. And as well, I mix some white, but I think I will skip the white, really. And I will start with this dark violet. I think that goes very well with both of these colors. Then I will add the gold, some of this sky blue. And then let's go with the copper. All right, so kind of a lot of color. I feel like the copper is already sinking. Maybe you see that. But then I will add some copper details later with the palette knife, because that's something I need to do. And so, yeah, for you guys, I'm pouring it now like this, you know, horizontal. But my idea is for this painting to hang it vertical. So, okay. Let's start blowing this a little bit over. This is beautiful. I think the copper is really sinking. Okay, so let's start blowing this out. Needs to be a Dutch pour. Very happy with the color combination, really. But there, I didn't blow really in the middle, so here's still so much color. Oh, well, I tackled that, so maybe I can do that with the palette knife. But first, I'm gonna torch this to see if some beautiful things will happen there. Well, not a lot. So there's a lot of negative space. That's something I really like. I do get a lot of comments about that, that you guys want me to blow it more out. Yeah, add some copper details. Well, Sarah, there are a lot of copper details, so I won't be adding them again, but I can do something with the palette knife. Let me really think about this, because I've never done something with the palette knife now, or maybe it's a better decision to let this dry and add some details with the palette knife later. But I feel like the idea was to use it now. Okay, so there's here a lot of color. I already said that, so maybe it would be a good idea to just do something like that. Yeah, it's kind of nice, so maybe. This does work, by the way, for creating some new small effects. So here's copper and gold. Maybe I can break that up a little bit. Yeah, it's kind of nice to use the palette knife, really. This is fun. So I do think it's such a good idea to use the palette knife if you have a lot of color in the middle, and if you blow it out, then you will touch the designs on the side. So maybe then it's fun to try with the palette knife. This is such a good idea. I'm not using it a lot. Just adding some very small lines, making the lines a little prettier. Yeah, maybe when it's dry, I will add some more things with the palette knife, who knows. This is beautiful. I really like these colors together. I think the design is perfect as well. Yes, yeah, Sarah, I really hope you love this one as well. I can't wait to see your piece. I've no clue as well what kind of technique Sarah is using. I didn't see hers. I guess we will see each other's painting when we upload, so the same time as you. So that's fun. So of course, guys, so if you want to know what kind of do's and don'ts I gave her, I think they were super fun. Go check out her channel and see her video. And otherwise, stick around on my channel. So yeah, I guess I'm gonna bring you up for a close-up because this just looks beautiful. Okay, so I think this would be the direction I would hang this because the composition is beautiful like that. I really love this part that I did with the palette knife. There, I did some with the palette knife as well. And here with that copper. Ah, these colors are beautiful. You see those cells here? Really love also that touch of the sky blue in there. Yep, I'm pretty happy. I would love to hear what you think about this and this color combination. Also gray, yeah, I love gray. And I did not use white. I think in 99% of my pours I use white. Even though the base has different colors. So yeah, okay, I'm gonna check out Sarah's video now. Can't wait, really. I hope you love this one. And yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you next time.